Hi folks, my name is Snigd. I am a digital artist and I work in the creative digital spectrum using 2D, 3D, motion graphics and visual effects. Since the last 9 years, I've also been teaching these forms of art. Today, we are going to learn how to create an animated slideshow in After Effects. And also I'm going to be teaching you how to beat match your cuts and transitions, which will make your slideshows look even better. I shall be open to questions, comments, and would love to see some work coming through. If you like what I teach, please consider subscribing and also press the bell icon for instant updates whenever I release a new video. If you're interested in following alongside as I teach, I encourage you to download the exercise files that I provide here in the description. I'm working on After Effects 2018, so the file that I will provide here will be compatible with After Effects 2018 and upwards. However, if you are on a lower version of After Effects, you may still utilize the assets and create your own file. I also share the relevant links in the description for the assets that I have used here. Let me walk you through the exercise files folder and show you around. Folder named as slideshow_01 is the project folder. As you go inside, slideshow_start is where you can start following alongside. slideshow_01 is the final output file. So let's open up the slideshow_start.aep file and head to the project panel. And after analyzing the images, let's create a composition by clicking on the film strip icon at the bottom of the project panel. That lets assume we are interested in having a composition half the current size. Well, that's very easy to do. All you have to do is divide the current number by 2. And After Effects will do the math on its own. As a result, we get 640 by 360 pixels. And similarly, we can multiply it too. Let's go down to the frame rate and bring it down to 29.97 FPS. Next, adjust the duration to be 4 minutes for now. Click OK. Right-click again on Comp 1 and go to the Composition Settings and rename it to something logical. So this is our music track to which we'll be editing the slideshow. Let's take a listen. Double-click the track and hit Spacebar. Spacebar again to stop it. Let's open the arrows here to reach out to the waveform. In the timeline panel, press the plus key to zoom into it quite a bit. And let's play it once again using spacebar. Okay, so try to notice that about every 1.5 seconds, there is a spike going up. Now that's what we call the beat. So I'm going to play it one more time for you to be able to see it. At this beat only, we are going to finally align our cuts or transitions. Now, let's reach out to the timecode in blue on the left here and control left click on it. It changes to frames instead of hours, minutes and seconds from its default. Okay, so this is about where the spike is and that's showing me frame number 58. And on the other side, it's 98. So let's open up the calculator and do a little math here. 98 minus 58 is 40. So my best guess is that the beat is around 40 frames apart, give or take. Close the arrow. Bring back the time slider to the initial position. Select them and left click and drag them to the layers section in the timeline area. Now since all the layers are still selected, If I click the visibility icon here, all of them will get switched off at once. Now let's go one layer at a time and switch on the visibility, scale them down and reposition it in the composition. I'll speed up the process here. Okay, we are done here with adjusting the proportions. Now, let's head to the end of the layers here in the timeline section. Left click and drag the duration of the layers to suit the requirements. Zoom into the timeline to get a better view. Again, drag them all to around 40 frames mark. Switch these on. Open up the scale values of all the layers together. Click on the stopwatch icon next to the scale value. Go back to the start of the timeline. Reduce the scale value a bit. Something like that. Right click and go to keyframe assistant, sequence layers. Now this is where the magic happens. Overlap, switch that on. This is going to give you a nice overlap between frames. What should be the duration of the overlap? Well, 20 frames. What should be the transition? Cross dissolve front and back layers. Okay, everything looks good. Okay, and let's take a look here. Well, definitely some adjustments to be done here in terms of syncing with the tempo of the music. Undo few steps using Ctrl Z or Command Z on Mac and readjust the duration of the images to around here. And let's repeat the keyframe assistant procedure. Here we go. Somehow the visibility is turned off. Let's switch that on. Wow, that's much better and really close to what I wanted. So this is where I wrap up the video. In this video, we saw how to take a couple of images and a background music track and edit them together using Keyframe Assistant. We also discussed how to figure out a beat to which you can match your cuts and transitions. So this is Snigdh signing off for now. See you next time. Till then, take care and never stop creating.